Welcome to the Luxury Listing Specialist Podcast with Michael Lafito, where top luxury agents reveal their best practices, plus interviews with real estate industry influencers, thought leaders, and luxury marketing experts. You'll come away from each episode with new strategies and tactics to dominate high-end homes in any market. And now for the latest episode of Luxury Listing Specialist. Here's your host, luxury real estate expert, coach, and trainer, Michael Lafito.
Welcome back to another episode of the Luxury Listing Specialist podcast. I'm your host, Michael Lafito. You're in the right place if you're a broker, owner, a team leader, an individual agent, and you're looking to work smarter, not harder. You're looking to increase your average sale price and increase the number of high-end and luxury properties you represent. Just like Kevin Costner said in The Field of Dreams, if you build the listing inventory, the buyers will naturally come. We love working with high-end and luxury buyers, as do our agents. But again, our focus is on building that listing inventory. Again, my contact information, you have any questions about today's show, you have any questions about our certification or something in general, or you want to nominate somebody for our show, please shoot me an email, michael@marketingluxurygroup.com, michael@marketinglutrygroup. Again, just a couple housekeeping items. First off, A, check us out on iTunes and Stitcher. Leave us a review if you're getting some great content. We need those reviews. If you've invested in our book, it's on Amazon, Luxury Listing Specials. Again, we need those reviews. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, marketingluxurygroup.com on YouTube, Marketing Luxury Group on YouTube. Again, Michael Lafito, before we dive into today's guest, just one quick thing. I've had a couple people say, hey, saw your shirt, saw you out at the Lab Coat event or this event. Where can I get some of that luxury specialist gear? Well, go to luxuryspecialistgear.com. Check it out. We got some great T-shirts, long sleeve shirts, sweatshirt, different color combinations for both male and female. We just released our American luxury flag. It's an awesome shirt. It's double-sided. Check it out. Go to luxuryspecialsgear.com. All right. Today's guest, I'm really excited. Him and I have known each other for about 8 or 9 years. For those of you that know my story, you know I was a former teacher, and I'm a marketer, right? I teach agents, don't think like a real estate agent, think like a marketer. And this guest and I met at a Dan Kennedy at a GKIC event, and he at the time was with a company called The Speaking Empire. They helped gurus, leading authorities become public speakers, helped with their slide deck and their pitch, so to speak. And Dustin was the CEO of the Speaking Empire, just a high character guy. Now he's with WealthFit. He's the CEO, the chief educational officer at WealthFit. And I'll let him tell you a little bit more about WealthFit. But Dustin, you there?
I'm here, Michael. I'm thrilled to be here, excited to share the good, so to say.
Hey, I appreciate it. You're a great guy, Dustin. He looks like he's 25 years old, but this guy, I'll tell you, hasn't aged. But he's got a beautiful family, and I believe you have a son, right?
I got two sons, and I got a baby girl on the way within 30 days. It's crazy.
That's right. You have two, that's right, and the third, and we were talking about that because I have my two oldest are boys, and my youngest is a daughter, so that's right. So thanks thanks again for joining me. And the topic really for today is reinventing yourself. So many of the agents listening today, Dustin, they didn't start out in real estate. And, you know, that story resonates with me as well. I started out as a full-time teacher and a part-time real estate agent. And the topic for today is really reinventing yourself, starting from scratch. And many of these agents started from scratch, or many of these agents are top agents listening, but they're starting their luxury division or starting luxury from scratch. And of course, our podcast and our content is one of the tools and resources we want them to be able to leverage. But let's talk a little bit about reinventing yourself. And although you're not in the real estate space, although you have a real estate investment background, and I met Than Merrill from Flip This House when you and I were meeting a couple weeks back at your office, talk to me a little bit about reinventing yourself. You stepped away from this great company that helped entrepreneurs at the Speaking Empire, and and kind of started from scratch, so to speak, and reinvented yourself. And you're interviewing some top authorities and CEOs and entrepreneurs and educators with your Get Wealth Fit show. And what are some common denominators from your experience and what you're seeing from other people that have reinvented themselves?
Well, that's a great question. To go even further back, what I've realized, and I think as you grow older, you realize like you invent yourself, even if you're in the same industry, like you reinvent the people that you hang out with, you reinvent the way you do certain things. And that's just life is what I've determined. And so for me, I got excited by Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Michael, you've read this book, yes?
Yes, absolutely. Robert Kiyosaki.
It's a classic. If folks listening haven't heard it, it is a great book to read. If anything, give it to kids or young ones. It will set them up correctly if they really hear the message. And so I got excited by real estate and went down to an investor club. And that led me to being a behind the scenes guy. And that's how I got to meet Michael, is through Dan Kennedy and understanding the power of marketing. And, you know, after my time there, I basically volunteered to work for free there. I reinvented myself and I said, I got to go do this for myself. And so that sort of led me into all different things and different, you know, paths and careers, and got to work with realtors and mortgage brokers and a lot of different folks in the real estate related services. Been around it so much that, you know, I ended up buying my first house. I did some pre-construction and now have some rental property. So very familiar with the real estate space. But the one thing that you really mentioned, Michael, was this company, Speaking Empire. This was my vision. This was my dream. And you know what I'm talking about. This is my baby. For 9 years, I put my blood, sweat, and tears into this company thinking I was going to have some magical Silicon Valley-like, you know, exit. And it was never in the cards. And quite honestly, it was never a business that was going to, you know, demand some sort of crazy multiples, more of a lifestyle business that paid well. But one day I woke up and I said, you know what? Do I want to be on this path? I asked myself this question. And I think part of reinvention, Michael, is slowing down a little bit. And in my case, my grandmother had passed away. And so for the very first time, I started questioning things because I was in this hustle mode and grinding. I'm going to do all this stuff. And for once, I slowed down and I asked myself that question. And the answer I said was, no, I don't want to be here in 5 years. And so I said, well, do you want to be on the same path in 3 years? And I said, no. And then I said, well, do you want to be on this path in 1 year? And the answer was no. And so I had to do something about it. And so basically I had my partners buy me out. And all I did was just leave that business behind. And it was tricky because my ego, my identity was attached to it. I didn't know who I was. And it was a very challenging time. And so I'm grateful for that. Fast forward, you know, 18 months now from that particular time, I'm doing what I'm doing what I love and I'm passionate about. And so I feel like everybody should reinvent, whether they leave a business or a profession, that's, you know, remains to be seen. You got to do what's right for you. But I feel like we should, especially people listening into this, you're looking for education, looking for new ideas. You should be like disrupting yourself like these big companies do. So in some form or fashion, so that you can get to that next level in your business. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it does. So reinventing yourself, stepping outside your comfort zone. You know, I did something just like that. I did it twice. So the first thing I did, for those of you that kind of remember or don't remember, I was a full-time high school PE teacher and football coach from 1998 to 2009-10 school year. And March 19th is the day I retired and literally stepped away from that to full-time real estate during the worst times. We had a 6 month at home and my wife was pregnant. And so my whole family said I was nuts. And so I burned the bridges, so to speak, and burned the boats. And I just said, listen, this is it. I'm full go, burning the boats. I'm not turning back. And I went full time. And that was the first thing. Then the second thing was in real estate. It was totally unheard of. But I joined an office about 40 minutes from my farming area, my market, from an area I was comfortable with. Didn't know anyone, didn't know it very well. But that was another thing that I did is I reinvented myself in a totally new market, in the luxury market, and these are all things that we try to teach people. So Dustin, talk to me a little bit about some of the things when you did this and some of the things that you interview some of these other people on your Get Wealth Fit show. What are some common denominators you're seeing?
Well, so I had the opportunity to interview Danica Patrick. If you're just getting to know her, you know, the winningest female race car driver of all time, like a true icon. And she recently retired from professional racing. And before she did, some of the things she was doing on the side was starting businesses. Now she's got all the time, you know, in the world essentially to devote to these four or five different business ventures that she has. And so one of the things is you've got to assemble a team. Now, if you are like leaving a profession, you may be leaving an entire team behind. If you are leaving an office or a brokerage, right, like you may have family members or team members there that you may be leaving behind. But the key thing in this is you got to have some sort of, some people call it a North Star, some people call it a sounding board, a coach, a mentor, a guide, you know, choose your word that really resonates with you. But you've got to have somebody to bounce your ideas off, because I'm here to tell you, and Michael, I'm sure you can share, reinventing wasn't easy. Like when you have your family, in Michael's case, telling them like you're crazy, and people are on the outside looking like you've got, you know, a young baby and you've got one on the way, it's you can second guess yourself. And so you've got to have someone in your life, or you know, in your personal life or business life, that supports you. And if you're fortunate, you can have a team of people, like a mastermind or a coaching group, for accountability, but also to get you out of your own head. And that was one of the things that Danica shared with me on the show, was just having, you know, the right people around you, because it's hard to see everything. And especially when you go through a transition like that, a reinvention, it's very difficult to separate like your emotion, because your world is in turmoil. And so you need folks that are, you know, grounded, that have your best interest at heart, that can, you know, tell you if you're on the path or off the path. That's just one of the things. And then I'd say the second biggest thing is that in all the folks I've interviewed, over 125 now for the Get Well Fit show, and we cover all things from money to personal finance to investments, all sorts of investments, to entrepreneurship, all sorts of different leaders in all those areas. And the commonality is we're all reinventing. Some of us are kicking and fighting and screaming into some of these reinventions, but that's just a nature of life. Some people call it growth. You may know it as that. But the commonality is, in order for us to grow, in order for us to experience new things, we got to step outside of that comfort zone. And when we do, it opens up new worlds. I mean, if we look at your story, Michael, like, you know, you were the teacher, then you got into real estate, but even more than just real estate, you're into luxury real estate. And so you've reinvented yourself multiple times. And that's what I found successful people do.
Hey there, it's Michael Lafito. Thanks again for listening to our podcast. If you are interested in signing up for our Luxury Listing Specialist certification, or if you want additional information on how you can dominate selling higher-end homes in your marketplace, make sure you go to luxurylistingspecialist.com.
So reinventing yourself, change, right? If we are in the industry right now of real estate, where disruption, disruptors is a common buzzword that I see at all these conferences. So this topic is very timely, reinventing yourself. Again, change isn't easy, but most people want change, but they don't want to change themselves, right? And so change isn't easy, reinventing yourself. Again, sometimes it's the environment, sometimes it's your staff, sometimes it's physically moving to another location. You know, sometimes your current environment is cancerous, it's toxic. So these are all factors when we're talking about reinventing yourself. You know, anything else to add to that?
Well, I was going to say, you know, when you feel comfortable, I just think back to when I was, you know, at the previous company that I had founded, life was comfortable, right? Like money was coming in. It's the classic dream. You know, I bought a house in a nice neighborhood. We rehabbed it. It was a bungalow. It actually had a white picket fence. It's crazy to kind of visualize that in my head. It had that. And life was comfortable. But you know, underneath that, I had been there for way too long. And so the tell sign, something that is a indicator, doesn't mean that you have to go disrupt yourself or reinvent yourself. But if you feel comfortable, if you feel stagnant, and that's really what you're looking for, like if you're sort of bored, this could be the opportunity. It doesn't mean that you have to do it, but I want you to think about this. You know, disruption is such a big word now, sort of a trendy word, but if you really think about it, some of these bigger companies, big institutions out there have departments called, you know, disruption, and they actually fund smaller divisions to try to disrupt themselves. Because if the reality is if you don't disrupt yourself or your business, someone's going to come along and do it. And I know agents are feeling that pressure with all these like tech tools, and they're looking at the tech space, and there's all this reports in the media. And so you sort of feel that pressure coming in. But even at a personal level, if you aren't disrupting yourself in some way, maybe it's a health thing, maybe it's I'm going to go learn a new language, maybe it's I'm going to, you know, play some investments somewhere outside of real estate. If you don't do that, then you're likely to get stagnant. You're likely to get stale. And so I want to challenge everyone listening to this to disrupt yourself in some way. Take something on. And the reality is, if you don't, some young gun agent is going to come behind you. Some technology agent's going to technology company is going to come behind you. And so be embracing it. And I know it sucks. Like, change is not easy. It's not fun. It's not great knowing what your next move's going to be, or that, you know, someone's breathing down your back. But this is life, right? If you look at it through history, you know, countless stores, Blockbuster out of business, right? Woolworths, if some people remember what that, like, there's so many examples of this. And so I tell people to embrace it and run towards it, build that muscle, get more familiar, and you'll get the results and you'll get what you're looking for out of life.
That's awesome. Great advice. Great advice. You know, switching topics a little bit, you and I, as I mentioned, a few weeks back, I was out in San Diego speaking at the Landfill Agents event, and came by your office, and it was great to meet some of your staff and get a tour of the facility, and your background and your show was really first class. So tell everybody about, you said, how many episodes have you released now?
We've done 125 episodes on the Get Wealth Fit show, which is just one of the things that we do around here. It's a podcast to, you know, build an audience, just like you do. It's a great strategy, even for agents, to make connections and relationships. But for us, we use it in that same way. We've done over 125 shows for the podcast itself.
That's mm-hmm. awesome. The background too, you have a nice studio. You also do a lot of videos. You're doing some great things, but I want to talk about gifting. Gifting is something that we're real big on. We have some really great customized boxes and swag gear, and, you know, people that are on our show, or, you know, if we're looking to bring value to an organization, you know, who doesn't like a gift? So as an agent, there's ways for you to differentiate yourself before an appointment. We call that your pre-listing package, or your rock star package. So pre-listing packages before you show up on the listing appointment, or sending a thank you, something personalized, different, maybe bringing it with you, a leave behind, or sending it. Gifting is a way to totally differentiate yourself. And, you know, we use these video books for those agents that have gotten our certification in the past. Depending on what incentive we were offering, many times we offer these video books that have a 10-inch monitor. There's an endorsed message. And I was showing you this, Dustin, at our meeting, and you pulled out this big box. You had a guest coming to your show, and you were looking at giving him for his time as a thank you. Tell us a little bit about this, and if you can release the name and
yeah,
some of the things that were in this big gifting box. It was really impressive, so much so that I wanted to talk about it on today's show.
fair enough. You know, I'll tell you this as a background. You know, Michael and I, we love marketing. I'm the type of guy that loves to be creative and give gifts to people. Now, I know that's not everyone listening to this show. You know, some people are more, you know, tactical, you know, driver driven. You know, the key strategy here is whether it's you or someone on your team where, like, it's more of a natural thing. Gifting just comes easy. They want to make an impression. They want to make somebody. That's the key strategy. Whether you do it yourself or you have someone on your team to do it is critical. And so another quick background. What we do here at WealthFit is we sell online courses for folks that want to get WealthFit, meaning they want to become better in investing or managing their money. And so one of my strategies is we have this podcast, which you could call it Lead Gen. And I know Michael talks about that, a relationship build. And then naturally, when I interview these folks, I invite them to create courses with us so then that we sell online. So that's sort of the background. So we have this guest, and I was very fortunate to get a warm introduction, which is a very, you know, powerful strategy and one of my favorites, because you don't have to sell. And if you get that referral in, I don't have to preach to the choir here, but I got a warm introduction. And basically, this gentleman said, yes, I will come down to San Diego and be on your show. Now, the first thing you should know is most podcasts are audio. Well, for VIPs, you want to think about rolling out the red carpet. So in this case, we have access to a studio. And though, although most of my stuff is done, you know, on a phone or on the internet, audio only, no pictures, I said, this is a VIP. Let's get the three cameras out and let's record this as a video podcast. Not only for our benefit here at WealthFit, but I said, you know what? I want to give you this gift. Here, just have all this footage, right? If this guy were to go to a studio, which he probably could get access to anyway, because he's a high-level guy, and I'll share his name in just a second. But I said, you know what? Let's lead with massive value. And so I have this asset. I'm very fortunate to have it. And I turned over all that footage to him. And so the gentleman that came down, that you're hanging on the edge of your seat, hopefully, is his name is Ken Cragen. Now, you might be saying, well, Dustin, who's that? Well, he was the guy that was behind We Are the World, which was that amazing song with over 40 like rockers and singers that raised money for Africa, for poverty, for hunger. And then also he orchestrated Hands Across America. If you don't know what that is, that's where 5.5 million people stood in line holding hands, singing We Are the World from coast to coast. And he's been the manager of Lionel Richie and Kenny Rogers and, you know, celeb and star and all that. So he's a high profile kind of guy. And I said, gosh, wouldn't it be great if he could create a course over his career of how to make an impact, how to do big things. And I said, man, that'd be amazing. So for me, I'm always looking to deliver value. And so he came in and I could have easily after the interview said, hey, will you create a course with us? But I read this guy's book in preparation for it. And he's all about creating the experience. That was one of his things. So using his own material that's available, buying his book, reading it to prepare for this interview, I said, I want to do something special. And so when he left, I put him in a car, which we rented for him to make his life easy, by the way. I packaged this shock and awe box, as Michael calls it. And inside of it had one of the key elements, which was a video book. And a video book, if you're unfamiliar, just hearing about it for the first time, it's a book you open and it just starts playing a video. So, you know, they don't have to turn on a computer. You don't have to turn an iPad on. It literally opens and starts playing, which is key because you can never assume people are going to know how to, you know, operate the thing or press play. But before that video book, I did the extra touch. And this is where it gets fun for a creative person. I went on eBay and I typed his name in and I found like all these like old clippings because he had done a lot of stuff in the media and, you know, because of his background. And so on eBay, this memorabilia was like $5 and then shipping. So like I bought four or five pieces, an old newspaper ad, an old picture of him and Lionel Richie, like a real photo, like press photo. And, you know, I invested $40, $50 on these materials. We bought a box, a nice black box. We put the memorabilia on. I put a letter inside. That letter was in an envelope with a wax seal because he's an older guy and he would love the ambiance and the choreography and the, you know, all of this. And we put it together and we put it in this box and we gave it to him. And, you know, thank you for spending time with us today. We appreciate what you've done for us. And gosh, we would love to be able to perpetuate your message through what we do here at WealthFit via a course. And so the key thing here is just going that extra mile, creating that experience and showing up like no one else. You know, when people are high profile, they get pitched every single day, you know, and there's no creativity. There's no thought behind it. And so if you really want to make an impact, get through gatekeepers. This is one of our favorite strategies.
Love it. Love it. So again, all the research that Dustin
did to find out more about this information, what the guy's passionate about, what he's done. Just kind of, again, the most listened to radio station that your prospective client listens to, and matter of fact, most people listen to, is WIIFM, What's in It for Me. And so the sooner you realize that, as soon as you know that a prospect's time and energy is very valuable, and as soon as you realize what keeps them awake at night and what you can do to help them, then when you're creating a memorable experience, when you're gifting, you know, all of these types of things are going to, you know, be huge when it comes down to, you know, helping these individuals. So, and sending a pre-listing package or a thank you note or a thank you gifting package. So that's just one example that, you know, it's not in the real estate industry, but some of my best ideas are outside of the industry. So again, we got Dustin here who's, you know, not a licensed real estate agent, not a luxury specialist. However, is sharing with you two key takeaways from today's show. Number one, reinventing yourself. Again, when you're going against the grain, whether it be within your industry, whether it be, you know what, I'm reinventing myself, I've been a buyer's agent or a short sale or REO specialist, and I'm gonna reinvent myself and I'm gonna be a luxury listing specialist. You know, that's an example of reinventing yourself within the industry, or I shared with you outside the industry, former teacher, now in real estate, et cetera. You guys, one of the things I'm very passionate about when I speak in front of live audiences, if there's 78 agents in the room, I guarantee you I can take those agents' experience, whether it be from high school, whether it be college, whether it be from a previous career, and help develop a unique value proposition, taking their experience from their previous careers and making that a point of differentiation in their real estate career. And most agents don't like talking about themselves, or they downplay what they did previously. I'm a stay-at-home mom all my life. How is that going to be incorporated into my unique value proposition? There's something from all of your backgrounds. And so that's the main reason I brought Dustin in, talking about reinventing yourself. And then the second big key nugget, talking about gifting, whether it be in pre-listing packages, whether it be bringing it on your listing appointment, whether it be, hey, at the closing, or whether it be post-listing appointment or post-buyer's appointment package, having some kind of gifting and differentiating yourself, because what is a sale worth for you? And what are you willing to cheerfully outspend your competition to differentiate yourself? And that's really what Dustin talked about. Him and I are both marketers. Now, Dustin, for anybody that wants to find out more about this Get Wealth Fit show, over 100 episodes, again, learning from successful people, I guarantee you Dustin's not going to have somebody on his show unless there's something that's a nugget or two that each of us as real estate brokers and agents and broker owners and team leaders, although they're outside the industry, guarantee you, you're going to walk away with some nuggets. So where can I find out more information about that?
Michael, thank you big time. You're spot on about that. Oftentimes the biggest breakthrough comes from looking outside the industries. I've done that myself. If folks are interested in getting exposed to new ideas outside of the industry, I believe you do both. Listen to Michael's show and get what's going on in the industry. Also, put yourself in environments outside the industry. If you have a desire for that and you know that you should be reinventing and diversifying, you can check out the podcast that we do here. It's a great show. It's called Get Wealth Fit. And it's very easy to find because if you know the name, you can just type that into Google, getwealthfit.com, and it'll take you right there. And if there's a desire to go above and beyond and overachieve and take some courses on, you know, how to invest in stocks or whatever your favorite asset class is, or start a business outside of real estate, we have courses at wealthfit.com.
Well, I appreciate it. And again, value what you're doing. Dustin is a big believer, and he is a lead with a giving hand. He doesn't have a scarcity mindset. You've always made time for me. I appreciate that about you. High character guy. So thank you again, Dustin Mathews. Get Wealth. Let me rephrase that. Dustin Mathews, he is all about helping not just wealth from a financial standpoint, but wealth from a mindset, from tools and resources, from a productivity, from working smarter, not harder. You know, that's really what I, when I think of you with Get Wealth, that's what I think of. And I don't think of the, you know, the gentleman that's just about financial, but it's all about the all encompassing. And that's what I really appreciate about you.
Well, thank you, sir. And you're exactly right. It's more than just money. It's creating wealth in all areas of your life. So thanks for having me on the show. And I really appreciate being on and sharing the wisdom today.
You're absolutely welcome. Just a reminder for those of you that have any questions, go ahead and shoot me an email, Michael at Marketing Luxury Group. Keep raising the bar. If you are interested in perhaps having us keynote an event or have us come out and do a luxury certification training, shoot us an email as well. We just got back. We were down in Miami for Coldwell Banker Island affiliate. So basically for all the island affiliates of Bahamas and St. Croix and British Virgin Islands, they had us down. We did a full day training. We toured a $17.5 million property and $6.5 million. It was a great experience. So if you guys are ever looking for outside presenters, keynote speakers, or to host a luxury certification, shoot me an email, Michael at Marketing Luxury Group. Check out luxuryspecialsgear.com. Leave us a review on our podcast as well as our book. And thank you again, and keep proving others wrong. My name is Michael Lafito. Until next time, we'll talk to you soon. Take care, everybody.